chestnuts roasting on an open fire, Jack Frost nipping at your nose.
Cookies, no, 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 no.
Keep your mind on your mask, kid. Horror form a classic. It's
drastic. Hey, everyone. Welcome to a special episode of High Movies. Tonight, we're going to go over the definitive Christmas movie list. This list is comprised of all my favorite holiday films and television shows that I watch every single year to get myself in the holiday spirit. As this episode's released on Christmas Day, this gives you a great opportunity to watch a movie that you haven't seen before or remind you of something that you've seen a long time ago that you just haven't watched in a while. So here's the thing, I'm an 80s baby, but I'm a 90s kid. So this list is entirely comprised of stuff that I grew up watching. Lucky for you guys, I'm dope as fuck and have great taste, so this list should appeal to the masses and everyone should be able to get something out of this and really enjoy themselves this holiday season. In order to do this properly, I had to break this list down into five categories. Old classics, shorts, TV episodes, Christmas adjacent movies, and holiday favorites. So essentially, I'm just gonna go through a couple of these movies in these categories. I'm not gonna go into too much detail because I really don't wanna spoil anything for you guys, especially if you haven't seen some of these films. Let's get started. So to kick off old classics, we've got Miracle on 34th Street, A Christmas Carol, and It's a Wonderful Life. So here's what's special about these movies. Each one of these films essentially started what we know today as the holiday film. So there are specific ways the story is told and specific ways the movie is filmed that are essentially used in the movies that we watch today. So if we're gonna talk about any of these movies today, we have to talk about these three because they're essentially the first of its kind. So when it comes to Miracle on 34th Street, you definitely wanna watch the original, the black and white version, not the updated version from the 1990s with the girl from Matilda. If you watch It's a Wonderful Life, you're gonna wanna watch the color one, especially if you're an 80s kid, just because it makes it a little bit easier and more fun to watch. Finally, we have Charles Dickens' A Christmas Carol. This story is the epitome of Christmas movies. It's been made so many times, I can't even keep count. As I said earlier, all these films are important. We can't talk about the rest of the list without at least mentioning these three first. Next, we're gonna talk about shorts. A short film is essentially any film that's not a feature-length film or anything that's less than 40 minutes. In this category, we have How the Grinch Stole Christmas, the animated version, Mickey's Christmas Carol, Frosty the Snowman, Rudolph, Little Drummer Boy, Santa Claus is Coming to Town, Garfield Christmas Special, A Flintstones Family Christmas, and A Charlie Brown Christmas. All these shorts are phenomenal. They're animated, they're family friendly, and they definitely get you in the Christmas spirit. Next, we have television episodes. This is definitely something you should check out, especially if you're a 90s kid, because everything on this list essentially revolves around late 80s and early 90s, and they would definitely get you in the holiday spirit. They bring back that nostalgia that everyone's looking for. But before we get into things, there are a few shows that aren't gonna be on this list. First and foremost, Friends. Friends isn't on here because although they do have holiday episodes, they're mostly known for Thanksgiving episodes. Their Thanksgiving episodes are essentially some of the best television programming for the Thanksgiving season. It's that, Charlie Brown, you got Dutch, and Planes, Trains, and Automobiles. That's what you wanna keep for Thanksgiving. So because those episodes are so good, they're not on this list. Second, we have Roseanne. While Roseanne is a great show and it had some holiday episodes, what they did really well was Halloween. Their Halloween episodes are fucking phenomenal. So again, that's another show that's not gonna be on this list. The third show is gonna be Home Improvement. Again, just like Roseanne, just like Friends, they have holiday episodes, but their Halloween episodes are awesome. Because those episodes are so good, they kind of outshine everything else and they're not gonna be on this list. Now I know those are three huge shows, they're not on the list, don't worry. Here are a few that are fucking awesome. So to start this list off, anything on TGIF. If you were alive in the 90s, I'm sure you watched TGIF. Any one of those shows, whether it be Full House, Family Matters, Hanging with Mr. Cooper, Step by Step, all of those shows have excellent Christmas episodes. Those are definitely something you should watch. Again, these are family friendly, they're fun. Anyone can watch them, you'll have a great time. Next on the list, Psych. Psych is one of my favorite fucking TV shows. It doesn't get enough credit, and they have amazing, amazing, amazing holiday episodes. It's a show that takes pride in nostalgia, and they go back and they give homage to actors, television shows, and movies of the past. Everything that we love, essentially. Another great show to watch is 30 Rock. 30 Rock has awesome, funny episodes. You just can't go wrong with them. If we're gonna talk about 30 Rock, we also have to talk about The Office. The Office has great holiday episodes. They're quick, they're fun, they're silly. Definitely check them out. Another holiday episode classic, Seinfeld. The Seinfeld Festivus episode is by far one of the silliest, ridiculous, and most memorable episodes that they've ever come up with. If you haven't seen it, run and check it out on Hulu. Rounding out the live action shows is SNL, Saturday Night Live. This show has been on for decades. They've got so many holiday episodes, and I'm pretty sure Hulu or YouTube has a compilation of all the greatest episodes and skits. So when it comes to holiday episodes, we have to talk about all the great animated series. You've got South Park, Simpsons, Family Guy, American Dad, Bob's Burgers. These shows are all awesome. They're very funny. This is something I get high as fucking watch every single year. The Family Guy Road to the North Pole is one of my favorite episodes. And also we have to mention the Simpsons Christmas Classic, season one, episode one, the Simpsons Christmas special. It's where they get Santa's little helper. It's where everything we came to know and love about the Simpsons started. So everything I've talked about so far, whether it be the classics, the shorts, or the television episodes, they've all been family friendly. The next category we're gonna talk about does not qualify for anything family friendly on this list. Now we come to the category of Christmas adjacent films. What are Christmas adjacent films? It's very easy to explain. Christmas adjacent films are films that take place during the holiday season, but don't really give you the warm, fuzzy feeling. A great example of this is Die Hard. Now there's been a lot of debate lately whether these movies are considered holiday films. And I'm gonna answer it right now. Of course they are. Starting the list off, Die Hard, Lethal Weapon, Batman Returns, Gremlins, Rocky IV, Just Friends, Why Him, Trading Places, Iron Man 3, Kiss Kiss Bang Bang, Friday After Next, LA Confidential, Ghostbusters 2, The Long Kiss Goodnight, Reindeer Games, and Fat Man. As I said earlier, all of these films take place in and around the Christmas season. If you have any problem or concerns with these films being considered Christmas movies, I'll tell you right now, you can go yourself. These are 100% Christmas movies. I'm not here to argue with you. I'm not here to debate you, because here's the thing. I'm right. You know it. I know it. The world knows it. Die Hard is a Christmas movie, and so is every other movie that I just mentioned. And finally, we've come to the last category, holiday musts. These are the films that you must watch every year. You can watch them with families, you can watch them with friends, you can watch them by yourself, and they will give you the warm, fuzzy feelings. These are the movies that were made for Christmas. There's no arguing and debates in these ones. This is the epitome of Christmas movies. I give you the best list you've heard ever. We're gonna start off with a very Harold and Kumar 3D Christmas. Get high as fuck and watch this movie. It's amazing, kids. It's amazing. Next, we have Office Christmas Party. I think Jason Bateman and TJ Miller fucking killed it in this movie. You should definitely check this one out. Following that, we have The Night Before with Seth Rogen, Anthony Mackie, and Joseph Gordon-Levitt. This is a great, stupid stoner movie. I have a blast with this every year. Do yourself a favor, blaze the fuck up and watch this movie. I promise you, you're gonna enjoy it. Next, I'm gonna hit you with that 1-2 punch. We got Four Christmases and Fred Claus. Both star Vince Vaughn, both are funny, both are family appropriate, and both get you in the Christmas spirit. Next on the list, Deck the Halls. This is a lesser known movie starring Danny DeVito and Matthew Broderick. It's a fun movie, it's a great time. It's not my favorite, but it has to be on this list. Next on the list, we've got The Christmas Chronicles. This movie stars Kurt Russell. It's great. I was honestly surprised. I thought this movie was gonna be like a spoof. I thought Kurt Russell was gonna be out there fucking people up. It's not that at all. This is a good, wholesome holiday film. You should definitely check it out with your kids. Moving on, we've got Ernest Saves Christmas. I'm not even gonna discuss this movie in detail. It's funny, it's silly, it's stupid. It stars Jim Varney. If you're an 80s kid, you know what the fuck this movie's about. Check this shit out. Then we've got Christmas with the Cranks, starring Tim Allen and Jamie Lee Curtis. This is a great film. It's based on a novel called Skipping Christmas. Dan Aykroyd's in this movie as well. It's fun, it's family friendly, age appropriate. Check it out. We've got Surviving Christmas with Ben Affleck and James Gandolfini. This is such an underrated movie. Not many people remember this. Not many people talk about it, but I tell you what, Ben Affleck was the fucking bomb in Phantoms. So if you know that, you know to watch this movie. The back and forth between James Gandolfini and Ben Affleck is fucking hilarious. Catherine O'Hara is also in this. This is an underrated film that not many people know about and definitely nobody talks about. Do yourself a favor and check this one out too. Now we get to the point of the list where all of these movies should be watched just before Christmas or on Christmas. These are the epitome of holiday films. These are the holiday musts. I have the whole list, the whole category of holiday musts. These are the top of the holiday musts. We've got How the Grinch Stole Christmas starring Jim Carrey. This is an amazing movie. If you haven't seen it yet, please do yourself a favor and check it out. If not for me, do it for Jim Carrey. This guy spent almost 10 hours a day just putting on that makeup. He deserves your respect. He deserves for you guys to watch it. And you guys deserve to enjoy yourselves. Next, we have the Arnold Schwarzenegger classic, Jingle All the Way. I don't know why, but I absolutely love this film. I think Arnold Schwarzenegger and Sinbad play off each other very well. It's a wholesome story. It's very, very meaningful. It's loving, it's caring. You should definitely check this out if you have kids. Bad Santa, Christmas Vacation, The Santa Claus starring Tim Allen. The first one, not two or three, just number one. Scrooge starring Bill Murray, Will Ferrell's Elf, both Home Alone 1 and 2, and finally, A Christmas Story. As I said earlier, all of these movies are holiday musts. Please do yourself a favor and check them all out. So I tried to do my best to provide you guys with the best, most comprehensive holiday movie and television list that you've ever seen. I want to thank you guys very much for listening to this podcast. From the bottom of my heart, I wish you guys a very Merry Christmas, a very happy holidays, and a very healthy and happy new year. Thanks for everything, guys. Do me a favor and smash that like button and subscribe to this channel for everything Absurd Reality. We are out!